NVIDIA's new RTX 3060 graphics card is here, but how does it compare against the RTX 2060 from last generation? Or going back even further to the popular GTX 1060? I've compared all three in 12 games at 1080p, 1440p, and 4K resolutions to show you what the differences are. The 1060 and 2060 both have 6GB of memory, though the 2060's is faster. The 3060 has double the memory capacity at 12GB while also having faster memory than the 2060. The 3060 has more CUDA cores than the others, but interestingly less RT cores than the older 2060, though the 3060s are second gen, so we'll see if this matters when testing some games with ray tracing. The 1060 launched almost 5 years ago now, but they're also easier to pick up secondhand and of course cheaper than the MSRP listed here. This is the system that I'm using to test all three GPUs in, so overclocked 10900K and 32GB of memory are the key specs. It's also worth noting the BIOS on my Z490 board was updated, so the 3060 was running with resizable bar enabled. This is not currently supported by the 10 or 20 series cards. Alright, so with all of that in mind, let's first have a look at how these three graphics cards compare in 12 different games at 3 resolutions. We'll also take a look at power draw, content creator workloads, pricing and availability, or lack thereof afterwards. Red Dead Redemption 2 was tested using the game's benchmark. I've got the 1080p results down the bottom, 1440p results in the middle, and 4K up the top. We can quickly see that both the 2060 and 3060 are offering nice gains when compared to the older 1060. However, the gap between the 2060 and 3060 is smaller comparatively. At 1080p high settings, the 3060 was reaching 24% higher average FPS compared to the 2060, while the 3060 had a massive 133% lead over the 1060, the biggest out of all 12 games at this resolution. Cyberpunk 2077 was tested in Little China with the StreetKid LifePath. These results are with ray tracing off. We'll look at ray tracing and DLSS in the next graph. This time the differences between the 2060 and 3060 were smaller. The 3060 was 13% faster than the 2060 at 1080p and 1440p, then 19% ahead at 4K. Granted, with these frames, you'd probably want to lower the settings. Here's how things look with the RT medium preset in use with DLSS set to quality. I don't have results from the GTX 1060 here. As it doesn't have ray tracing hardware, it's not able to run. The differences between the 2060 and 3060 were now much larger. The 3060 was 39% ahead at 1080p and 65% at 1440p, the biggest gap between these two GPUs out of the 12 games tested. So it looks like there might be some nice gains in terms of ray tracing with the 3060 over the 2060. Let's check out another title with ray tracing support and see if that's the case. Like Cyberpunk, Control was tested with and without ray tracing, and we'll start with ray tracing off results. I've found this game to be heavy on the GPU, and that's especially the case given I'm testing with max settings here. Both the 2060 and 3060 were far ahead of the 1060 here. At 1080p, the 3060 was 129% higher than the 1060 in average FPS, but it only had a 19% lead when compared to the 2060. Based on this, it would appear that the 2060 was an awesome upgrade over the 1060, but the 3060 not so much of an upgrade compared to the 2060 before it. And I'm not even considering the 2060 Super, which would sit in between them. Here's how things change by enabling both ray tracing and DLSS. Again, no results for the 1060 as it doesn't have ray tracing support. The 3060 is actually performing better at all three resolutions with ray tracing and DLSS compared to just running at stock, which is kind of impressive stuff. The results from the 2060 are more mixed. Some resolutions saw gains while others lowered back a bit, ultimately resulting in the 3060 being 22% ahead of the 2060 at 1080p and 1440p. So a slightly larger gap compared to the 19% difference we saw just before with ray tracing off. It's worth noting that the differences between these two GPUs at 4K was the largest seen out of all 12 titles. It's hard to say if this is the new ray tracing hardware helping, or it could just be the fact that the 3060 has double the VRAM capacity. Microsoft Flight Simulator was tested in the Sydney Landing Challenge. The 3060 at 1080p was the only option that could deliver more than 60fps. Granted, you could of course run with lower settings should you want to prefer a smoother experience. Higher settings are generally more GPU dependent, which is important for a comparison like this. The 3060 was reaching more than twice the average FPS of the 1060 at 1440p, a big improvement, while the 3060 was only 22% ahead of the 2060 in this same test. Even the 1% lows of the 2060 were beating the averages of the 1060. Assassin's Creed Valhalla was tested with the game's benchmark. Again, the 1% lows from the 2060 were ahead of even the average FPS of the 1060. The new 3060 was only able to do this to the 2060 at 4K, where average FPS FPS was 48% higher. The difference was smaller at lower resolutions though, with the 3060 23% ahead of the 2060 at 1440p and 18% ahead at 1080p. Watch Dogs Legion was also tested with the game's benchmark. 1080p on the 3060 was the only configuration that could surpass 60fps with the highest ultra setting preset. This time the 1% lows from the 3060 were all ahead of the average FPS of the 2060 at all resolutions. There's an above average difference when compared to the other 11 games tested here, with the 3060 offering a nice boost compared to the 2060. Let's see if there are any big differences for esports titles. Fortnite was tested with the replay feature with the exact same replay used for all three graphics cards. This was another where the 1% lows from the 3060 could surpass even the average FPS from the 2060. The 3060 was able to offer more than 2x higher average frame rate when compared to the 1060 at all three resolutions. While that sounds nice, and it is, as you'll see later though, this was actually the case with most games. CSGO was tested with the Uletical FPS benchmark, and typically depends more on CPU performance than GPU. The 1% low difference between the 2060 and 3060 was minor at all three resolutions. The difference to average FPS was also small too. This game saw the smallest improvement when comparing all 12 titles that I've tested. Rainbow Six Siege was tested with the game's benchmark using Vulkan. This was another where the 3060 was able to produce more than 2x the frames when compared to the older 1060. There's a fair difference between the 3060 and 2060 too. It's just not as much of a boost. The 3060 was around 22% faster at all resolutions. Battlefield 5 was tested in campaign mode. At 1080p, the 3060 was reaching 21% higher average FPS when compared to the 2060, but this increases to a 33% lead at 1440p, then a much larger 52% increase at 4K, outlining that the difference increases as the resolution rises. Second last game before the big comparison, Shadow of the Tomb Raider was tested with the game's benchmark. This one had an above average improvement with the 3060 when compared to the 2060. Meanwhile, the 3060 was reaching more than twice the average FPS that the 1060 was capable of. The Witcher 3 is a game that I've been testing the same way for about 5 years now, so it's a good one to throw in if you want to see how results compare to any of my older videos. Anyway, there was a much smaller difference between the 2060 and 3060 here, hardly worth an upgrade at all, though this is an older game, and both were much better when compared to the 1060. These are the differences in all 12 titles tested between the RTX 3060 and GTX 1060 at 1080p. The 3060 was almost 100% faster, or around twice the average FPS on average, so a pretty decent boost. Most people with a 1060 are probably running around 1080p, so yeah, in the games I've tested, here on average you can expect a 2x boost with the 3060. This increases to a 109% improvement going from 1060 to 3060 with the higher 1440p resolution. The 1060 is capable of 1440p in some games. It of course depends on the setting levels used, but again the point remains that on average more than a 2x boost can be possible with an upgrade. 4K isn't really where the 1060 was aimed at, so I suppose this one is more of a for science result, as this resolution is loading up the GPUs nicely, leading to an average 133% boost with the 3060. Now let's look at how the 2060 and 3060 compare. At 1080p, the 3060 was 22% ahead on average, so a much smaller difference compared to the older 1060. It of course varies by game, but for the most part, I think this is a pretty small difference. Things increase at 1440p with the 3060 now on average around 27% faster than the 2060 in these selection of games. It depends on the title, but some like Cyberpunk saw small differences, that is with ray tracing off. With ray tracing enabled, the 3060 seems to have a nice lead over the 2060, at least in this game, as the control result with ray tracing on was more in line with the rest of the games. This changes at 4K though. The top two results are ray tracing tests, but as outlined earlier, it's hard to say how much of this improvement is solely due to ray tracing hardware upgrades with the 30 series, and how much may be due to the 3060 having double the VRAM, as that's going to be pretty important at this higher resolution. I've got a dedicated RTX test soon though, so stay tuned. Despite performing better in control at 4K, the RTX 3060 was actually using slightly less power than the 2060, though the two were close. The 1060 is using less power, but the 3060 was also reaching 236% higher average FPS in this test. Basically, the 3060 is winning here in terms of performance per watt, as it was capable of hitting higher FPS while drawing a little less power in the same system. I haven't tested thermals here, as all of my graphics cards have different cooling designs, so temperatures will vary due to this, it just wouldn't be a fair comparison. Now let's check out the differences in content creator workloads, followed by pricing afterwards. I've tested DaVinci Resolve with the Puget Systems benchmark. This software seems to be fairly GPU heavy, though the difference differences were far smaller when compared to the games just covered. The 3060 was reaching a 16% higher score compared to the 2060, but a 68% higher score compared to the older 1060. Adobe Premiere was also tested with the Puget Systems benchmark. However, the GPU seems to be less of a factor here. The 2060 and 3060 were scoring very close together, and the 3060 was scoring around 25% higher than the 1060. It was a different story in the V-Ray benchmark though. The 3060 was reaching a 250% higher score compared to the 1060 in the CUDA test, or 46% higher compared to the 2060. V-Ray also offers a ray tracing test, and the 3060 was around 60% higher in this one, shown by the darker purple bars. Blender was tested with the OpenData benchmark with the BMW and Classroom tests using CUDA. The 3060 was 237% faster than the 1060 in the longer Classroom test, or 112% ahead of the 2060, more than 2 times faster. So there can be some bigger differences between the 2060 and 3060 outside of gaming. Now let's discuss price. According to Nvidia, the RTX 3060 is launching with an MSRP of $330. Good luck with that. Based on the shortages and high prices of other GPUs at the moment, that just seems pretty unlikely. Cortex has reported prices closer to $500 prior to launch. Unfortunately, I'm making this video prior to launch, so I haven't been able to confirm. But you can check out updated prices with the links down in the description. Of course, assuming there's actually stock. The 2060 had a more expensive $350 MSRP when it launched in 2019. But checking Newegg and sorting from lowest, well, let's just say things aren't looking good there either. Even secondhand 1060s are currently on eBay for around $200. So yeah, definitely not good times out there. Due to these crazy price differences, I just don't feel comfortable making my usual performance per dollar graph. Sure, I could use the MSRPs, but that's not particularly useful as you can't buy them at those prices. That said, hopefully things do get under control in the future. So with that in mind, I have made the graph. But again, it's not really going to be particularly useful unless things come back to normal. I only decided to add it into the video at the last minute just in case it helps someone months from now when prices might be more normal. Basically, assuming MSRP prices, the 3060 wins. It performs better for the money regardless of resolution. In a normal world, the 1060 and 2060 would be available for less secondhand, but that's not the case currently. I guess you could argue, why make this video at all if you can't buy any of these? And look, I get where you're coming from. But fact is, some people will actually be able to get their hands on these. So why not have that data out there to make an informed decision? Plus, I do believe the content will be useful later on. Whether that's 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, a year, I have no idea. It really does suck, but that's just the way it is at the moment. Assuming prices do actually get to their MSRP, basically to summarize, the 3060 is cheaper than the 2060, but also performs better. If you already have a 2060, it's not really worth upgrading to the 3060. In most cases, the performance gains just weren't that big. But if you're still on a 1060, then upgrading to a 3060 would be a pretty big improvement. So that's pretty much it. If you're new to the channel, get subscribed for more upcoming GPU comparisons and tech videos like this one. And I guess let me know in the comments if you would get a 3060 if it was actually reasonably priced and in stock.